Hey everybody, welcome back once again. Today we're doing something a little bit different. We're working on our floor machine. We've got a blown circuit breaker down here. So what we're going to do is take off the panel. And see what we have back here. So it looks like we've got at least one wire that's been pulled out, but we got to figure out where that's from. Actually, it doesn't appear that wire's ever been crimped. So, what we're gonna do is grab a little pair of pliers to be able to take off the circuit breaker. It won't reset. Now this particular one has been discontinued, so we have to use the other size. So now we have a circuit breaker installed. I'm going to go ahead and put this panel back in. Just loosely though, because for right now, it doesn't have to be all the way tight. I just don't want it to fall out. Also going to replace the actual vacuum on this because the vacuum doesn't suck anymore. And that kind of sucks that the vacuum doesn't, because that just means that my floor machine requires me to use a squeegee every time I use it. So this is kind of a slow Friday. Not lots going on, which every now and then is kind of nice because it allows you to get some stuff done in the shop that you otherwise wouldn't be able to get done. So now once we turn this machine on, should have water coming out. And we still don't, which is fine, because I do have a new water valve for the machine as well. So I have this valve to replace right along with this. But the next thing we're going to do is the vacuum. The vacuum doesn't vacuum anymore, so we'll flip this thing over and pull this out, replace the vacuum unit. So the next thing I gotta do is reach in here
and access these.
So we're gonna need a little bit more of an extension. Reach all the way down there where that is and be able to swing the ratchet. That rubber gasket. when you put them together. However, I don't really like the wire nuts. So what we're gonna do is use actual butt connectors. So we're gonna get a couple of blue butt connectors. Another blue butt connector. And splice it in. See, these are the shrink tube style butt connectors. So we're going to get out a little torch. And go ahead and shrink our shrink tubes. So we got a nice tight seal. So that's done. Next thing is to go down underneath and take off that water pump, or not water pump, solenoid valve for the water. Thank you. we'll move over here. So this is in a really bad location. There's not a lot of room to get to the fasteners. I'm sure I could probably get this thing on a lift and be able to get under it, but I'm just not sure it would help that much. Okay, so there's that. Okay, there's one hose on. So now we got our solenoid valve out. So hopefully, once I get this put back in with a new one, it will seal up and work. Take this panel off, not panel, but bracket, so we can swap it over to this solenoid and then bolt it back on to the floor machine here. Important to remember which direction this little bracket faces so we can make sure and put it back on the right way. So you see it went like that. So what we're going to do is just a little bit different. We're going to go ahead and put that in and drop this in on top of it. But when we put this back on, it's going to go on the bottom side instead of the top side. That's in. Now the next thing to do this piece goes into a cable here that turns the solenoid valve. So what we got to do is try to get the tip of this slid into the slot on that so it will line up properly. There it is, lined up. So now the next thing I gotta do is get this hose back in its place. Okay, so there's that. I'm getting my hair in the water. That's always fun. Thankfully, it's got a lot of cleaner in it, so it won't be that dirty. Okay. Yeah, but is it putting out any water?
Yeah. Here's that little coming out.